All right, Captains, it is time for the U.S. Navy's premium Tier 7 destroyer, Sims. For me, she is as fun as playing my hot Lana, and she has quite easily become one of my most favorite ships to play in the game. I was so happy that Santa brought more than coal this year to my stockings in the form of several destroyers, and the Sims was one such treat. Thank you, Santa. Because the Sims sure does love to treat himself to little enemy destroyers. Nom nom nom! Doesn't matter where you are, who you are, the Sims can wreck a lot of lives. Now, as far as gameplay, the Sims definitely takes a divergence away from the Atlanta and resembles more closely the Tier 9 US destroyer Fletcher. I really think of the Sims as a Fletcher Lite, as she carries the same guns that the Fletcher does, minus one. But the lovely shell arcs, same turret rotation, same reload rate, and the lovely shell velocity, they are exactamundo to the Fletchers. So you learn how to shoot in the Fletcher, you too can piss off battleships concealed in your smoke cloud, free from the threat of Eden Torpedo's broadside. You too can rain your terror upon battleships with your relentless onslaught of hot lead. 2 minutes to the tune of 30,000 points of damage. As she is armed with torpedoes, and oh my, are they super slow? Please fast forward, Fetch. And oh boy, do they not pack a punch, really, whatsoever. But to highlight how slow they are, take a gander at the clock. 12:13 on the clock. Prepare to fast forward, fast forward. Cue elevator music, and they're still swimming. Almost a minute later, they reach their target for a measly 5,600 points of damage. And that's what you're gonna expect, guys. See a lot of 5,000 numbers, a couple of 6,000 numbers every now and then, maybe a 7 here or there, and once in a blue moon, an 8K damage torpedo hit.
I think I'll perplex him with my slow ball.
But that's right, Bugs. Just like in baseball, these change-up torpedoes can really catch an enemy off guard. My, oh my. Now with her ridiculous reload and spamming potential of her guns, and the ridiculous speed of the torps, but potential for flooding, you can stack some serious damage on enemy vessels to the tune of, say, 40,000 points of damage. That's right, turn into my torps. They ain't coming, they're super slow, they ain't there. Touchdown!
Excellent.
Now some may consider these low-skilled torpedoes, the old saying goes, I would rather be lucky than good. No, I meant this all the way. Strike one on the nose. Strike two on the butt that you thought you were getting away from. And three strikes, you're out. And speaking of multiple strikes, Captains, when you learn how to torp in your Fletcher, you learn where the enemies like to hang out so you can send your fishies for a pre-dawn raid. Double strike! And of course, like all US destroyers, the YOLO solo carpe diem run around islands is quite viable in The Sims, but you best damn be sure that you land all your little fishies on target. Otherwise, you will be the fool who is pitied. That torpedo beat. Hot damn, that's another thing about The Sims that I love is this rudder shift. Her maneuverability is just insane. But sometimes, Captains, I just can't watch. And then there are other times where you are forced to watch by the game. No, Stormy, no! And then, of course, Captains, there are those instances in which you are just super stoked to be the spectator. Take down this Benny. Come on, Fetch. Ho-whack! Whoa, who took him out? Minnow did. Oh, Minnow. North Carolina. Whack, double strike. Delight, Minnow. Oh, let's see that again in instant replay. Goodbye, Benny. Got the torpedoes on the port side. Say hello to my little fish.
Don't want to just see that shit in the next segment. Watch this YOLO in the Gneisenhow.
All right, captains. Well, I have a pretty long replay. I hope you all stick it out towards the end for a little bit of action, perhaps. But in this replay, you'll see some things that you might like, some things that you might not like about The Sims. But the replay itself was just too good not to show. But if you're all in a hurry to find out my thoughts on The Sims, then go ahead and check in the comment section and skip ahead to the dollars and cents portion. But if not, sit back, grab your popcorn, and enjoy. Alright, this match sees us bottom tier on the map Loop Division with my buddy Minnow and Carrier Junior, aka Stolme. Now you can see in my captain skills, I got a pretty nice captain. I haven't put the final 3 points on him yet because I'm still trying to sort out what I want to do. Adrenaline Rush looks very nasty, and so too does just Superintendent for extra smoke and go-go fast. But as always in US Destroyers, I really like Survivability Expert so I can slug it out with enemy destroyers and walk away with at least some of my teeth still intact. I, of course, do not want to go for AFT because the rainbow is outrageous as it is already. So no need to try to rainbow stuff at 15 plus kilometers because that just ain't happening. And in my mods, I went for the second torpedoes. The first ones are the shorter range and faster, but I don't like those. I go for the long, slow guys. Went for better AA even though it's rubbish. Steering gears to try to mitigate the engine knockouts. And go fast because you turn on a dime already. And I want to maintain my speed and have the ability to stop and get on the gas. PDQ. All right, well, we have the South Central spawn and we are gonna mosey on into B cap. All right, my torpedo reload rate is very nice, so I'm gonna launch some preemptive strikes down the channels where DDs most likely are to come down, right down that middle section on that side of the middle island on the B cap and to the west and east, you know, but I only have two sets of torpedoes, so let's see if I can get some joy and catch a couple of DDs off guard with these change-up torpedoes. All right, well, there is a party in C and a party in A, but most likely we probably won't run into anybody. Their enemy battleships are oriented towards A, and I have detected, oh crap, there is an enemy DD. My detection range is 6-6, which isn't the greatest for a tier 7, especially going against tier 9s, and oh my god, there is a Yugo, and there is a cruiser, oh my god! Whoop, boom! Oh, Mr. Edinburgh, why'd you do that to me? Why'd you do that to me? That hurt a lot! I'll keep firing, pop my smoke. Oh, hot damn. Stormy hit his radar to keep this Yugo detected so we can put him down. Unfortunately, we can't shoot on the Edinburgh right now. Oh, incoming torpedoes. Go back, go forward, dance in between them. Oh, let's put down this Yugo and first blood. Yugo down. Okay, Edinburgh, I owe you some pain. And oh, he goes dock. Radar is out. He is in his smoke. Come on, boys. Firing on where his shells are coming from. And no joy. But look at that. My torpedoes are up and ready to be fired again. So I'm going to shoot into his smoke, try to shoot into the center. And maybe I was thinking behind that he might be reversing into a smoke. I mean, look at those. Those things are so slow. I mean, the Sims is so fast, you could almost torpedo yourself. Now, Stormy had to run. He's hiding in my smoke. And wow. That was rough. 4,900 health points. Oh, wow. Just to start. We're barely a couple minutes in the game. Edinburgh is still there. Looks like he dodged the friendly torpedoes. Mine are still swimming. They haven't even left the cap zone yet. Oh, my God. Oh, they're so slow. But maybe they're slow enough to catch them off guard. But okay, we have a Tirpitz who is in the shit. He is going against a Benny and a couple of battleships, so I need to probably start moseying on that way to help him out. But I'm worried about this Edinburgh. Oh, there he is. There's the Edinburgh, and he is running away. Those torpedoes have not a chance in hell of hitting him or maybe anybody else, but All right, here we go. Let my boys know you got about 30 seconds left on my smoke counter. Then you all need to start running for the hills. Tarpitz is going YOLO solo into the smoke and into the lion's den, man. The pit of doom, it looks like. You got a Yorkie, another Tarpitz. There was at least two more battleships, it looked like, probably coming in onto the A-cap on the north side. And of course, that Benson is there in his own smoke. He's laying into the Tarpitz something fierce. Yep, Gneisen out and a Moggy. Now, when you have your torpedoes, you can shift zoom in all the way and see where these guys are heading. I do have the Gneisen out picked. And I am guesstimating that they're gonna come a little bit more shallow east of that island that they're, looks like they're trying to notch themselves into. Oh, there's the Benson, come on, Benson. Come on, shoot on him, shoot. Oh, tier eight, gotta put him down. He is very dangerous. He can really wreck some lives. Nice hits, come on. Here we go, come on, can we get him? No, I think our Tirpitz is dead. Oh, yeah, Benson is down, thanks to the Tirpitz, but the Tirpitz is too, man. Ugh. Full broadside of Benson torpedoes. That's like 10 torps, man, and that is good night city. I don't care who you is. That's gonna hurt a lot. Maybe Yammies could probably laugh that off, but ugh. All right, well, I engaged my speed boost. I'm trying to haul some butt. Got a Yorkie and a Tirpitz shooting at me. Oh, there was another ship. Oh, North Carolina. Oh, man, and a cruiser that was joining the Amagi and the Gneisen now. My torpedoes are still sailing, I guarantee it. I don't know if they're gonna hit anybody, though. And maybe they might hit somebody. They just throwing shit at the wall, guys, and you just hope something sticks. It's not gonna be stinky, but you know it will be a little sticky. Okay, Yorkie is getting too close for comfort. I gotta pop my smoke. I do have my speed boost still going, but I want to try to sit here and pop him down. I have a hipper, I think, that is to my 4 o'clock 5 o'clock. So I'm gonna try to work on him. He is keeping this Yorkie spotted. So let's see if I can burn him, give him some burning love. Oh, almost from the hipper on him. We did get some good hits. Come on. I am running the, of course, high explosive. It's just all my captain skills. And I'm still trying to figure out if it's good or not. I've done a bunch of games without it. Oh, that's a nice hit though. And score some really good damage, and I've done a bunch of games with it and score some good damage. Oh, there's a fire though too, sweet. Yes, more, come on. Oh, I used another fire, but he of course was immune. Oh, he is, yep, come on, this is gonna take him down. Come on, here we go. Oh, 594, please fetch, put him down, Yorkie down. Oh, all right, well, they are going toe-to-toe. Last time I saw the enemy fleet, they were moving on into B. So I was thinking that Tirpitz was going to come north of the island here on my 3 o'clock. So I was going to launch some slow fish just into that zone. And oh, rubbish, there he is. He is coming the long way around and not going up into the middle. Crap balls. Well, I got to wait another 45 seconds for my torpedoes to come up. Oh, Miyoko, and there's the Tirpitz. Oh, this isn't going to be good. Smoke. Speed boost, torpedoes, Tirpitz is coming in. Oh, I do light a fire. My hipper was dead though, and I'm okay. So, but his spot plane is still detecting this Tirpitz because of the fire now. All I can hope is just to burn this guy, burn him down, and hopefully land a few torpedoes on him. Because otherwise, I am SOL shit out of luck right now. This is not looking good. Okay, I light another fire. 1188, you can see a lot of my rounds, guys, are just breaking apart on this Tirpitz's face. It's okay. He's hitting me in the face. And that's something you're going to see a lot in this thing, which is why I tried, oh crap, I am detected, which is why I tried the HEAP stuff. Now, I did launch my fish expecting him to turn shallow and nose in on me, trying to make himself skinny. But he hits the brakes a little bit, so maybe they might connect. And his secondaries are just unloading on me. Oh, I do light him a fire again. Oh, incoming. And oh, that tickles me a bit. Knocks out my steering. And oh, what was that? How did that torpedo not hit him? I swear to God, that scraped his side. Oh my God, there's a big old key scrape on the side of his hull. I swear to you. Come on, can we get around this island? Gotta run away, try to hide behind this island. Oh, please, knocks out my steering again. Oh, come on. Oh, somewhat safe. I still am detected because there's an enemy Miyoko and Gneisen now up there, but they got their own problems to worry about right now, and the Miyoko's turrets take forever to turn. So, okay, smoke is finally up again. and I am going to try to engage it, maybe extend it just a little bit to try to, extend my zone in which I can, like, hide and engage the enemy turpets. Oh, there's a spotter craft, there's a spotter plane. I gotta stop. He can't detect me. I do have my AA off. Oh man, this is lame. Why is this turpus not detected? Okay, well, I got a North Carolina I gotta work on. Oh wow, 66,000 points. Oh my God, he is full health. I gotta try to rainbow some love in his way. Oh, there's the turpus. He's running away back up into the cap. Oh crap. Oh, well, let's see. Gonna pepper him now. Let's switch to the turpets. I know he had used his damage control. So let's see if I can light a fire on his decks and try to, whittle him down. I know that North Carolina, he is full health, so it's kind of pointless to shoot at him, but here goes the rainbow effect. Oh, okay, it's nickel and dimes, nickels. Oh, and there's a fire. Nice, excelente. Here we go. I am, of course, down to 911 health right now, but our team is looking okay. I mean, points are kind of tight right now, but we do got one more ship than they do, although, I mean, it's, 1/30th of a ship more than they do, and yours truly. All right, I'm trying to lead the rainbow, walk the rainbow onto the decks of this turpets. Some shells are landing, a lot of shells are smashed. Oh, Miyoko is hurting. Oh, can we take him down? They are now down to 3 ships to our 5, well, 4 1/30th. So let's help on this Miyoko. The lead, it's really tough to try to hit cruisers at range in this thing. Let's see what I mean. Oh, Miyoko down. You see what I mean about not needing the AFT, because, 15 and a half, I think, kilometers with AFT. It is just ridiculous to try to hit anything with this. All right, well, here we go, man. 4 1/30th V2. Now, one of them is pretty healthy. Our NC is kind of low, but we got an Otago, we got a Bismarck, and we got Stormy, who is hurting. And our North Carolina is down. Friendly NC goes down to the enemy NC. All right, the Tirpitz is lit afire yet again, probably from the Otago, the fire breather Otago. I'm going to see if I can compound his misery, or at least just piss him off with some pepper and take out an AA. Come on, let's start landing some shells there, Fetch. Walk that rainbow onto his decks. Light some fires if I can. Oh, that'd be so helpful. Okay, that's good. I take out his starboard side torpedoes. Those are dead. He has a DED dead. Ain't coming back from that. And I light him a fire, but the SOB used, and he used his damage control, so of course that fire doesn't stick. Boo! Oh, and of course I light him again on fire, number 2. And of course he's still immune. Crap, man, you know how hard it is to even just land shells on these guys, let alone get a fire? Come on, all right, Jesus, come on, game, give me a fire. He's hurting. All right, he's using his repair and his damage control to try to regain some health. Oh, man. Okay, it's now 3-2. Stormy is hurting, and our Bismarck is yelling witness. Oh, crap, man. He's going YOLO on this NC, trying for a ram or something like that. And, man. Torpedoes. Oh, no. Oh, friendly fire. Oh, crap balls. Our Otago takes down our friendly Bismarck. Oh, no. Oh, so that leaves a North Carolina who's damn near full. Oh, there he is. Turn. 6.6 detection range. 6.7. Oh, my God. Oh, that was super close. Oh, my goodness gracious, man. The pucker factor was maximum right there. Holy guacamole. Now, I do launch my slow-ass fish, trying to maybe catch this North Carolina. Oh, Stormy is down. Stormy down. He was out of smoke and out of luck, and oh my goodness, and now he's out of a ship and out of this game. Oh crap. Now, I did launch my fish hoping that the North Carolina might just, run into him, just decide to drop anchor and catch them all broadside, because that could take them down, but no, they ain't happening. Oh, and I am the last hope. Oh my God, y'all heard that right. You are the last hope. Oh crap. 911 hit point sins versus pretty full health North Carolina. But a Tirpitz who is just limping around, Oh, lordy, we are down on points, down on ships, down on health. Oh, my word, what to do? All right, well, I need to cap this and then work to go cap B. They might try to cap C. That he says go for C, but that just could be propaganda, false intel campaign. But then again, he is low health and he does want to run away from me, because remember, I have a 10.6 kilometer invisifire range. It's pretty rubbish versus cruisers and destroyers, but definitely very viable to do that to big, ugly battleships. Now, hit the brakes. I gotta stay, gotta cap, 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 cap. Oh, just got that base capture. Oh, that would have sucked had I walked out of there with just less than a second on the clock. Oh, that would have really been a detriment to the war effort right there. Now, I was trying to line up that North Carolina, but he is, I'm not sure where he's going. I think he might try to swing south into the B cap there on the east side of the northwest island on B. So I need to be careful. It's only 9.2 kilometers. The mileage on these square grids are about five kilometers from end to end. Oh, there he is. Remember, 6-6. Now I'm gonna launch my fish, hopefully that he's gonna head nose into this cap zone, and I'm just gonna kind of spread the love around. I just wanna start making some contact and maybe push these guys away from me, you know, because they're gonna be scared seeing fish. They don't like that alarm, battleship captains, so they're gonna run away from that. But I gotta be careful because there are spotter aircraft in the game for both the Torps and for the NC. And if they have the new captain skill that gives you two planes, then oh my, I could be in a world of hurt, PDQ. Now I'm heading south of this island, and I'm gonna try to move up into the B cap, because I gotta cap it out. Look, we are still way down on points, 4.5 on the clock, 2v1/30th of a ship. Now the Torps was last seen going into sea. I was thinking, well, okay, he's probably going to be doing there's a North Carolina, and he is turning away. Excellent. That is good. That's exactly what I want. I was thinking that maybe the Torps is going to be doing a little bit of a button hook pattern around that island on the west side of the sea cap between B and C there on the 7 line. And if he does that, this is going to be very dangerous. The North Carolina is turning back in. I'm going to start heading more towards him because I know the distance between us. But I'm really concerned about this Torps popping around this headland here and then just popping me one right in the mouth and ending this game. Oh, this is close. All right, he is capped, so he could be leaving the cap zone right now. Where is he? Oh, there he is, tally-ho on the Torps. Oh, there he is, 10 kilometers. All right. Now I'm gonna guesstimate that he is gonna turn sharp, hard right and head right out towards into B cap and have maybe do a little bit of a pincer move with that North Carolina, because look at this, I am walking the knife edge now, captains. 8 kilometers, 8.5 kilometers. Launch my torpedoes, hopefully gonna pop this Torps one. That would be all he had. He is looking, he knows exactly where I am. Oh, NC, less than 8 kilometers. Oh, Torps, less than 8 kilometers. Oh my God, I do capture B. Oh man, 7-7, North Carolina still there. Oh no. Oh, there's a, oh, there was a spotter plane. Oh my God. Oh, have your AA off, captains. Press the letter P and turn off your AA. Holy crap, that could have been nasty. All right, we are still down on points. I don't think we have enough on the clock, so I need to go in to C-cap. Now, I did engage my speed boost, and my torpedoes are back up, and I am, again, guesstimating that this Torps is gonna have to turn hard into B, so I'm just blind fire, best guesstimate, a wild-ass guess on where this Torps is gonna be. I hold my second set, just because I don't know what he's doing. This Torps has already shown himself to be a little bit of a sneaky bugger, and I want to make sure, because if I could take him down, I will assure us the victory. Don't know where that North Carolina is. Maybe he's going into the A-cap. Oh, it's getting close. Oh, there's the Torps shooting solution. There he is. Oh, 7.1 kilometers away. I launched my fish again. They give him the second set, and the first set looks like it's, oh my God,
Yes, touchdown! Oh my god! Good night, Terpets. Hello, victory! Oh my word. Oh, my little slow fishies, one land on the Terpets when it counted to give us the victory! Oh my god, Captains. Holy Hannah Montana, that was just out of control. That was close. That was really close, man. Because that Terpets could have gone back into B-Cap. Yeah, well played, Sims. Hey, congratulations, you two there, Guido. Salutes back at you, man. Can you carry any harder? I don't know, man. My heart is fluttering. My palms are sweaty. My knees are shaking. And the pucker factor was through the roof, so I don't think I could, guys. Oh, and the A-Cap was tripped. That is where the North Carolina was. Oh my word, oh my god. Captains, I'm glad you stuck it out for the full replay to see the Sims carry the team with 911 hit points to victory. All right, Captains, and there we go. Victory, V-I-T-C-R-O-Y, victory, victory. That's my cry. 3 kills, 205 shells landed, 1 torpedo for the victory, 9 fires for a total of 76,500 points of damage. But look at that, 3 base captors, 1 base assist for first blood. Guarantee that's going to be a high base XP right there. And look at that, tops of the charts, 3 kills, 2,959 base experience points. Whew, go Sims! And in the detail report, 392 shots fired, 205 landed for just under 50,000 points of damage. 1 torpedo strike for 3,900, but look at that, out of 72 fired. Oh my god, I wasted a lot of money on that one. Oh my goodness, 72 shot, 1 landed. That's all I needed, though. That's all I needed. 9 fires for 22,500 points of damage. And after taxes with a premium account in my premium Sims, 376,000 credits. Cha-ching! Big payday from the Sims. And even with that, with that standard account, over 200,000 credits earned. All right, Captains, we will roll right into the dollars and cents. All right, Captains, should you buy the Sims? Should you make her a part of your fleet as she currently sits for sale on the North American server? And I do believe in game for some doubloons. She costs around $25. Do I think that it is a good ship for y'all to get on the average player? No, I do not. But what I do recommend to actually make that ultimate decision for yourself is to work up to her closest equivalent, and that is the Tier 9 US Destroyer Fletcher. If you all get yourself into a Fletcher and succeed, then you would have a reasonable expectation of succeeding in your Sims gameplay, because the skills and techniques that you're gonna learn up the US Navy Destroyer grind, and then especially in the Fletcher herself, are gonna be supremely beneficial to your Sims experience. The torpedo experience that you gained in the Fletcher battling tier 10 opponents has really made you learn how to feel out enemies, where they're going, where they're heading, what are they thinking, and where best to put my torpedoes. And that is exactly what you need to do in your Sims, because those torpedoes are super duper slow. You really need to anticipate where the enemy is going if you have a snowball's chance of landing any of them, let alone all of them. And that is something that the Fletcher will definitely drive home. But if you get to the Fletcher and you aren't succeeding, then by all means, guys, do not get yourself a Sims. I don't think it'll work for you. I really don't. I love this ship tremendously. I think she is brilliant in my hands, and there are definitely other players that can make her sing to high heavens. But for the average captain, guys, she can be a very, very tough lady to live with. Oh, my word. All right, Captains, well, that was the U.S. Navy's Premium Tier 7 Destroyer, Sims. Like I've been saying throughout the video, I really enjoy this ship, but she is certainly not for everybody. There is such a high skill level ceiling in this thing. I mean, I'm sure there are some captains that break the mold and could jump right into her and just make her work and get a lot of good games out of her. Like I have, look at these games, man, just some insane numbers. I had a whole bunch of games to choose from and all these score screens. But for those who certainly have not worked your way up the U.S. destroyer line, this is definitely not a ship you want to get to do your captain retraining in. She's just a very difficult ship, just like the Atlanta. The Atlanta I love to pieces, but I cannot recommend her for the average player because there's just too much that can go wrong real quick in her. But captains, at only $25, she does fit within a good budget, especially if you're on like the 3 or 6 month budgeting plan. Maybe that can have a little bit of influence on your Sims purchasing. And of course, it's a lot easier now with the captain skill rework to get a concealment expert captain there. And maybe that will help mitigate the pains that a lot of new Sims captains have. All right, captains. Well, I know there's plenty more that could probably be said about the Sims that I haven't said. So if you have any questions, comments, or clean jokes, leave them in the comment section below and I will do my best to answer each and all. But in any case, I hope you all enjoyed the video and learned a little bit about my favorite ship, Sims. So until next time, captains, I will see you all in-game. Have fun. Fair seas.